Hi there, I'm Evangelist Matthew Lee, and welcome to today's edition of From Heaven at 7. Family, the portion of scripture we're going to be reading from today comes from the book of Proverbs, chapter 3, verses 9 and 10, and I particularly like how the Passion Translation says it, and it reads as follows. Glorify God with all your wealth, honoring Him with your very best, with every increase that comes to you. Then every dimension of your life will overflow with blessings from an uncontainable source of inner joy. And the New Living Translation says it like this. Honor the Lord with your wealth and with the very best part of everything you produce. Then He will fill your barns with grain and your vats will overflow with good wine. Family, isn't that just such a beautiful portion of scripture? And I know that this particular portion of scripture is speaking about finances, which isn't something that's particularly popular among church discussions. However, it's something that I feel the Lord wants me to speak to you about here today in this message concerning the scripture, family. You see, the scripture is telling us that we need to glorify God with all our wealth, honoring Him with our very best. Family, if you go and read your Bible, you will find countless scriptures about tithes and offerings and honoring the Lord with our wealth. And you'll find it in both the New Testament and the Old Testament. A lot of people say it's not something that's in the New Testament, but it is. If you go and look at the teachings of Jesus, you will actually see that Jesus spoke more about finances than He did about heaven and hell combined. That's a scary fact, family, but that is how important this topic is to God. And that is also why the Bible says in the book of Matthew that we cannot serve two gods, for we will love one and hate the other. We cannot serve both God and money. You see, family, that is the only time in the Bible that it says we can serve either or, either God or money. It doesn't say we can either serve God or the devil, or we can either serve God or sin. It says we can either serve God or we're serving our money. And I can tell you this from experience, family, that if we take a close look at our bank accounts, it can become very evident whether we are honoring God with our money or whether we are keeping our money for ourselves. Family, I know that this is a difficult topic to hear, and I want to speak to you about this from personal experience because I too, at one stage in my early walk with Christ, also had the perspective of, you know, why does God need my finances? Why do I need to give my money? It's my money. I've earned it. Why must I give it to the church? The church is just going to spend it and, you know, buy the pastor a new car or a new suit and stuff like that. I had that mindset. However, in my first year of Bible college, God spoke to me very clearly and told me that I needed to start tithing. And consequently, I made the decision that I was going to be obedient. And I began tithing and I began sowing the seed and I began being obedient to what the Lord was telling me to. I began honoring God with my finances. And when I made the decision to do this, family, God rewarded me abundantly. He started bringing money in from unexpected sources. At that stage, I was a freelance photographer. He started bringing in all these different new and wonderful clients that were bringing in all these finances and stuff. Why? Because I chose to honor God with my finances. And every bit of increase I received from those clients, every bit of increase I received from those unexpected sources, I would go and tithe on it and honor the Lord with my finances, family. And consequently, God took me from strength to strength, from glory to glory, and from victory to victory, family. And that is why I want to speak to you about this message, about this topic today. Not for me, not for the church, but for you, family, so that you too may walk in the abundant blessings that God has for you. Because when we put God first in our finances, He will make sure we are rewarded. You can never outgive God, family. The Bible says in Luke chapter 6, verse 38, that if we give, it will be given to us in full, pressed down, shaken together to make room for more, running over and poured out into our laps, that the amount that we give determines the amount that we get back, family. You see, whenever we give and honor God with our money, by giving offerings into the church and returning our tithe, God rewards us abundantly for it, family. He rewards us by returning what we gave, and He gives us even more on top of that. Just like when you sow seeds into the ground for a harvest of, say, corn or something, or millies. What happens? You sow a couple of millie seeds. What happens? Millie stalks pop up with a whole bunch of millies with even more seeds on it, family. And that's exactly how it works in the kingdom of God. You see, there's the universal concept of seed, time, and harvest. When we sow our seed and honor the Lord with our finances, it's just a matter of time before we will reap the harvest, family. And I want to encourage you, if you've been sowing your seed, if you've been returning your tithe, call in your harvest. Pray to the Lord and say, Lord, I've sown this. I've been obedient. I've honored you with my finances. I call in my harvest in Jesus' mighty name. And I can guarantee you, family, that harvest is coming your way, because the Bible says God is not mocked. Go and read Malachi chapter 3. In Malachi chapter 3, it speaks about tithes and offerings. And God even says, test me on this and he will show you. Test him, family. I want to encourage you today to make the decision to put God first and honor him with your finances, to put him first in your finances, to return your tithe and to sow seeds and use your finances for the advancing of the kingdom of God, family. And when you do this, I know that he will reward you. It's not about what the church does with it, whether the church goes and expands the kingdom of God or whether the church goes and buys the pastor a new car with the money. That's not on you, family. You've been obedient by sowing your seed and God will reward you for that. However, if the pastor's gone and been irresponsible with that money, that's on him and he'll have to answer to God for that. So don't worry about what's going to happen with the money. Just worry about your obedience to God. And when you do that, family, God will reward you abundantly. He will increase your vats. Your barns will overflow, family. The scripture is there. It's a promise that we can stand on. Thank you, family. I hope that this message has blessed you and encouraged you and given you something to think about. And before I end, I'd just like to close in prayer. Father God, we come to you in Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you for this day, that this is the day that you have made and we can rejoice and be glad in it. Lord, we thank you for this scripture today, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that you are doing a work in each and every one of our hearts and in each and every one of our minds, Lord, to grow, shape, mold, and transform us, Lord, in the area of finances, in our lives, Lord, in our perspective of giving and honoring you with our finances. Lord, we pray, Lord, that those of us who still have walls up concerning this topic, Lord, that you will do a work within us to break these walls down, Lord. We pray, Lord, that you will give us the strength that we need to honor you with our finances and put you first, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, that we know that as we do this, Lord, you will reward us, Lord, abundantly. Lord, I pray, Lord, that you will show yourself strong on each and every person's behalf who makes the decision today to honor you with their finances, Lord, and you will reward them abundantly for their acts of obedience, Lord. And we give you alone all the praise, the glory, and the adoration for every increase that you bring about in our lives as a result of our acts of obedience from this day forward with regarding our finances and putting you and honoring you with our finances. In Jesus' mighty name we pray, amen. Thanks for watching my video. I trust that the message blessed you and encouraged you. And if it did, I'd like to ask you to please hit the share button to spread this message and share it with your friends and family on social media so that they too may be blessed by this message. And before you leave, please give this video a thumbs up, drop a comment, let me know what you think about the contents of the video. And I'd like to invite you to please come back and join me for more episodes of From Heaven at 7, which premiere live every Monday to Friday at 7 a.m. Central African time on my Facebook page as well as my YouTube channel, where the replays of the videos remain for those who are unable to watch the live premiere. If you watched this message today and were touched by this message and feel like you want to give your heart to the Lord and make the decision to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, I would love to invite you to please click on the link in the description of this video that says salvation. And if you watched this message and felt blessed by it and feel led to sow a seed into the ministry, I'd like to encourage you to please click on the link in the description of this video that says giving. Alternatively, at the bottom of the screen right now is the ministry's banking details as well as our SnapScan QR code. And lastly, I would just like to ask you to please go and like and follow all my social media accounts if you haven't already, to be kept up to date and in the loop with everything that's happening in the ministry and every time we upload a video just like this one. Thank you, family. Enjoy the rest of your day and God bless. Yeah.